For a complete beginner, improvising may seem like a daunting task, but don't worry, the concept is relatively easy to understand. Improvising is basically a skill that can be learned and doesn't require talent, it requires a lot of work. We will work with a very basic improvising concept. As the harmonies go by, we select notes from each chord out of which we create a melody. While doing this, we are free to use other notes as long as they sound good. Fortunately, there are a couple of simple rules to choose from various notes and patterns on the fretboard, and this will make our life easier. Every musical composition will have some chords being played in the background, and our role as an improviser is to create melody on top of this musical background that will work nicely. Just as a painter will use background color and find a matching color for painting over it, we should analyze the backing track and find matching notes that we can use with it. In order to make an example of this, we will begin with the C major key. This key has 7 notes: C, D, E, F, G, A, and B. And the scale is being repeated in octaves. These 7 notes build 7 chords, and these 7 chords are unique to C major key. C major, D minor, E minor, F major, G major, A minor, and B diminished. A good improviser must learn all these chords and learn notes within each chord. We will start from C major chord first. We have our C major scale, and we will take C, E, and G and play them all at once to get a C major sound. Now there are actually lots of things we can do over this chord, and now let's try to improvise a bit by playing with strong notes. Here is C major arpeggio on the neck, and we can use this as a guide. We can play C, and another C. Let's play it an octave higher as well. And another. Okay, let's play now E, and we can play it here. We can play it here as well. Or here. Or here. Or here. Okay. And now let's play the G note from this arpeggio. We can play it here, or here, or here, or here, or here. Okay, now let's try to combine these notes together, C, E, and G. And here. Now if you stop for a second, you will see that all we do at the moment is choose the notes that are within the chords and it sounds good. Now let's try some more combinations over the backing track. For example, we can use C, E, G, E, C example. Now let's try it. There are many ways to play these notes as well, so you should try it. Use the backing track and play a bit more with the strong notes, while using this arpeggio pattern as a guideline. Try to enrich your phrases rhythmically. For example, instead of playing, you can try something like this. strong notes over C major chord. This can sound a bit boring and we have lots of more notes on the neck. Question is, what notes to use? Well, since we are in the key of C major, let's combine these three notes with other four from the key. Now we have a total of seven notes. And let's keep ourselves in the position 1 of the C major scale on the 8th fret. We will work the position up and down for a bit. This will get us familiar with it.